We can either stand or just, or sit. Sit, it might be a little hard to sit, I don't know.
Seems like a little sandbox.
Okay.
Can everybody see?
Is that fine? Okay. So.
So you.
Oh, you're welcome, you're welcome. We're so happy to be a part.
And Jay, thank you, Jay.
Of this, and the WeSpark fundraiser is just so important to us to be so helpful, because we know it's important to you, so.
Thank you, I appreciate the support.
Oh, tell us a little bit about WeSpark.
Well, WeSpark is a nonprofit, it's a cancer support center that offers free services to cancer patients and their loved ones. And Wendy Jo Sperber was the founder, she had breast cancer, and she invited me to, she said, oh, you're into all the woo-woo stuff, so why don't you come and help me do this? So that was back in 2001, it opened, and she dubbed me the program director, and I started creating all of these different programs for people, and now 17 years later, just to give you an idea, we have support groups and we have a lot of individual services for, which are nurse navigator and nutrition and Reiki and hypnotherapy and on and on and on. You can look at the website and see. But last year we provided 11,000 individual appointments to cancer patients and their families, and it's all free. It isn't just for breast cancer, it's for all forms of cancer, and we have a great men's group and kids, and I wish we didn't have to be there, but since we are, at least we're providing a lot of support. So very grateful for everyone's donation to the raffle tonight. Thank you, and thank you both Stephen and Paul for inviting me.
You're welcome.
It's a pleasure.
And just a brief little story about your interaction with Wendy in I Want to Hold Your Hand and how you became friends after that. And if you want to just tell us how that felt to just know her and her journey through WeSpark.
I love telling a story about meeting Wendy for the first time. It was the first day of rehearsal on I Want to Hold Your Hand, and I showed up at the rehearsal studio on La Cienega, and I walked in, and this whirling thing was, which was Wendy, turning cartwheels across the room and across the room and across the room, and so all I saw was this whirling thing, and she stood in front of me and said, hi, I'm Wendy, and I always think it's such a perfect visual image of her, because she was so full of life and so full of fun and so busy, you know, living, even when she was sick with cancer. She always said, I'm not dying of cancer, I'm living with cancer. And we were really just kindred spirits. And she looked up to me because I had made one movie, or two movies. One was right after Carrie, and she said, I haven't made a movie, and maybe you can give me some tips. So we became really close friends, and I became her advocate. I used to go with her for her treatments and to doctor appointments, and somehow we managed to laugh our way through everything. I don't know how, but we did. She just had a tremendous sense of humor, and I loved her. And knowing her changed my life. I mean, the fact that I can tell you that I love being part of this organization and doing the work and being with people, it's just, I mean, I don't know. It's just amazing to me. So, and the fact that I've had history in the entertainment industry, and there are a lot of people who we've worked with who are supporters, but it really does help with fundraising and helping with awareness. So anyway,